Cari fratelli e sorelle, and welcome to my weekly video blog. This is a bumper blog, and it's a bumper blog because the last week I did a weekly video blog and I uploaded it to Facebook, and I don't know what happened to it, but it was all corrupted. Occasionally this happens, and if I'm not in a good mood, or if I'm running late, as I was both of those last week, I just don't bother. I let it roll over to the next week. So apologies for the people who are going to have belated birthday wishes this week. This is my last full week at, well, it's not even a full week, but it's the last week at work before my retreat holiday. And my retreat holiday, as usual, is over the week in August that has the 8th in it, because the 8th is a very important date for me. And if you don't know about that, there are plenty of videos that you can look at that will talk about New Life Day and what that means to me. So it's a time that I usually have off, and do you know, I have a lot of stuff to do, and I think mainly because I have not been in a good place, really, throughout 2015 and the start of 2016, and I am rushing to try and catch up on stuff that I should have done a long time ago. It's hard to keep on top of things when you're going through a depressive cycle, as I think I have been at least for the last year and a half. It's very hard to keep on top of things when you are in a crisis of faith as well. A lot of those were caused by several events that happened all at the same time. Things like, for example, failing dismally at the close of the five-year plan. Things also with my family. You know, I love the fact that I am now, you know, an uncle to several children. But it came at a point of time where, because I can't have children myself, because I never will have children, there is a bit of a bittersweet sort of thing. And do you know, it was the first time that I'd ever sort of been, you know, it had ever really hit me like that, I suppose. And there were other things as well, like, for example, when you're passing a milestone, like sort of a decade in the same job, for example, and you feel like, you know, you're old and you haven't got a career that you want, if that makes sense. We're not talking about a job, we're not talking about making money, we're talking about one's life's work, professionally speaking. It's just a little bit like, well, you know, there are good reasons. You know, I'm lucky to have a job, really, in the tumultuous times that we've been through in the last decade, and various things have stopped me, I suppose, from starting out on a true career, a career path. And all these things got me down a little bit. And then, of course, we went into the winter, and, you know, that didn't help either. So I feel like I have got a lot of catching up to do. And so all the next week with the, sorry, all the week after, really, with the retreat holiday, it's all taken up with stuff. Therefore, I'm doing a lot to prepare for it this week. On top of that, we have a whistle-stop tour coming up. Yes, we do. We are off to Newcastle this weekend, in fact. I said it was my last week at work. It is not, in fact, a full week. I have Saturday off, and I finish early on a Friday. So we're going straight away on Friday. We're going to stay the night. We've got all of Saturday to sort of cover Newcastle. We're staying another night. Then we're going to do the cathedral, I hope, on the Sunday before coming back. So it's going to be a busy 2 weeks. There's lots to do, there's lots to catch up on, but I have planned very thoroughly for this, and I am confident that if I can sort of maintain, I suppose, my stability, then I can, you know, move from strength to strength. I don't think it's going to be an easy process, but I am sort of prepared to work at these areas, whereas in the past sometimes I have not been so prepared, I guess, to put words into action, maybe. You know, I can't speak about the past is over, and all one can do from here on, I suppose, is move on. And so it's best foot forward. There has been a triumph this week. It's basically none of my doing so much as the end of the war with my neighbour, in fact. Fruit Loop is leaving, yes. Feather Smail Scales, which is the landlord, popped up the to let sign outside her house. Oh gosh, middle of this last week, or was it the week before? I can't remember. sometime after the last video blog. You know, I still had no communication with her since I made my other video blog, you know, solely about the issues that I'd had. But in the next sort of month or two, I'm expecting her to ship out. And here's hoping that the next people that move in will be, you know, a little less troublesome.